by the Laplace transform of the initial value problem, this one. So you're gonna use the derivative theorem here. So on the left side, I have s squared times capital Y of s minus s times y of 0 minus y prime of 0, that's for y double prime, plus 16 y of 0 capital Y of 0 equals. So for this one, this is a direct delta function, and the theorem for this says that the Laplace transform of delta equals e to the negative s times this one, so you have negative 2 pi s. If you don't remember, just I have it written down here. So L of delta t minus t naught equal e to negative s t naught. So this is the base, and whatever t naught is, you just plug it in. Okay. Now take a look at the conditions. Y of 0 equals 0, so this becomes 0. Y prime of 0 equals 0, so this becomes 0. Okay. So factor out capital Y of s, I have s squared plus 16 equals e to the negative 2 pi s. Now divide both sides by s squared plus 16. Okay, then take the L inverse on both sides. So this one, I have u of t minus 2 pi, okay? But this one, s squared plus 16, looks similar to psi, right? If you have psi kt, that will give you k over s squared plus k squared. So this is going to be 4 squared, and you don't have the 4 on top. So in order to make 4, I just put the 4 in, and then I have to divide it by 4. So basically, I multiply the whole thing by 4 over 4, okay? And this gives me psi 40. Okay? But you also have the unit step function, which means that the t has to match up with this t over here. So this t has to be t minus 2 pi. Okay? And don't forget you have 1/4 on in front. Right? So now, if you want to double check, you just take the Laplace transform of all of this, and it should definitely give you this one. Okay? So this is your final solution. That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.